Obviously, the music business has changed a little bit.
Oh, gosh.
Over the past 35 years or so.
What music business?
Tell me more about that.
There's not much music business left, unfortunately. They kind of... The digital age just kind of messed up the pooch on that one. And it's sad because people don't have... They don't put perception or value on music anymore because it's all free. And it's sad for writers and artists. You go out and spend $150,000 on an album or $500,000 and people want it for free. And it's just like, okay, that's just the way it is. And I mean, I'm not really touring, so it's like I'm putting that kind of money into doing an album because I love to do music, not because I want to make money out of it. I'm not going to make money out of it, very little. And it's never going to be enough to come back and pay for what I did. But I don't do it for that anymore, especially maybe I did in my early career. But now I do it because I love it. I honestly love it. It's my passion is to write music and produce a song, be in the studio as an engineer, get the best sounds I can, bring in, work with the best musicians that I can. And to me, that's the thrill. And I don't want that to go away. It's kind of a drug. It's like a drug. It's a wonderful drug. Music is incredible. And I want to change lives as far as not change lives, but change hearts, change people for 5 minutes. And hopefully something sticks, but an idea or a story that sticks with them that they go, you know, that really changed me or made me think, you know, that kind of thing. That's why I do it. I mean, so the music industry is not why I do it anymore. There is none. And it's sad. It really is sad. I hope they change it someday for the sake of all these artists coming up because they don't know it yet, but there is no business unless they want to just get in a truck and tour the rest of their lives. But anyway, you just got to love it to stay in it. You got to love it.